What is up, everybody? Wesley Malott here, and today we're going to continue our conversations with Philip and Chloe Carroll, the filmmaking team behind The Honeymoon Phase, which is now available on video on demand. Today we are going to talk to them about casting and working with a named actor on their very first feature film, so let's get into it.
What was it like working with Francois from Lost?
Oh my gosh, it was like a dream come true. Like, Lost is by far my favorite piece of media, like anything, video game, movie, TV show. Like, if I could choose one thing on an island, no pun intended, it would be Lost. So when I was writing this script, I always pictured the character of the director as Francois. So on Thanksgiving of 2017, I reached out to him and he got back to me that day saying that, you know, he was flattered to get my email and would love to read the script. So I sent him the script. He said he was interested, and now he's in the movie. So it was absolutely incredible working with him. He, like, when he walked on set, it was like, oh my gosh, like, he's like the Hollywood person here, you know, like it legitimized the production. I think for all of us, that, like, you could feel the air change in the room. It was the only time I was nervous on set was like the first like 2 minutes when he was there. Cause I was like, oh my gosh, like first time feature filmmaker here collaborating with Francois. But then you just focus on the task at hand, which is bringing the story to life. And Francois was a master at that. You know, he just inhabited the character. I learned so much from him, you know, his experiences, like the blocking rehearsals were so much fun just watching him like feel out the scene, you know, as a professional actor. With so much, you know, experience under his belt.
So the first day was the day that I wasn't on set as an actor, so I was kind of just there with production, and he was sat in the room where you could just chill and while you waited to be on set, and like no one was going in. Everyone was just like, should we just give him, you know, some space? And I was so nervous to go sit in there. And then the other days when I did have scenes with him, like, I just had to pretend he wasn't famous because it would have weirded me out. Like, I would have been, like, nervous, more nervous than I already was on set. And then it wasn't until the last day that I had with him where, I think it was before my last scene with him, where we were, like, sat next to each other and I was like, can I get a picture with you? Like, I hadn't asked him the whole time because I, you know, didn't want to be one of those like fun girls, like, and make him be like, yeah, you know, it's fine. But I did on the last day because it was my last opportunity. But for the whole shoot, like, it was just, you know, you just normal, like you're talking with normal actors, and then just couldn't hold it back. It's just really exciting.
One of the things that I mentioned with Francois, which was so true, and I really appreciated his collaboration on the film, was on the day of his biggest scene. He came up to me in the morning and he's like, Phil, can we talk through the scene together before we shoot? And I was like, sure. And it was just the two of us, and he's like, I don't know if he would monologue like this here. Like, it just feels like it's like, oh, I'm the evil guy monologue. And I was like, you know, like, I totally agree with you. And when an actor has to do something that doesn't fit within the character that they created, it can be very challenging. Right. So together we sat down and we kind of worked through the beats to figure out, okay, why is he saying this right now? How can the character that Francois created of the director make this work logically in his mind? And also for me, how can I tweak the lines or the blocking to make this make sense to the character that he created? And it was a really beautiful moment of collaboration that we had. And it really, you know, it was one of those classic things, like when you're watching a movie, you're like, oh, I don't think he would say that right there. I don't think the villain would do that right there. Just kill him. And Francois called me out on it, and it was great. You know, it was really cool.
And that is going to do it for today's video. Just a really quick reminder that The Honeymoon Phase is available across a multitude of video on demand services, such as Amazon Prime, and link to the rental is in the description below in case you're interested in checking the film out for yourself. The full 2-hour interview with Philip and Chloe is available to our Patreon supporters, so if you're interested in checking that out and or want to support our channel, links to the Patreon are in the description below. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, please like it, share it, subscribe to the channel, drop a comment below, and we'll see you next week where we talk to Phil and Chloe about getting a distribution deal for their very first feature film.